Hi there, folks, and thanks for clicking on Close Up. You know, public worker unions were blindsided last week when House Republicans attached to their budget plan an amendment which threatens collective bargaining as we know it. It drew hundreds to the State House in protest, not only for the amendment itself, but by the way it was put into play. And for that reason, the House budget bill as a whole may be dead on arrival when it reaches the Republican-held Senate.
I have not talked to a single senator who will vote for the budget with that provision in it. The public hearing process is important. The process is important. And I haven't talked to a single one who will support it.
Sort of a disgrace in terms of what our legislature normally does for transparency and good government. There was no public hearing. It has nothing to do with the state budget at this point in time.
What it does is, for the first time, puts the taxpayer at the table so that the taxpayers have a role in determining what compensation will be. Without this sort of provision, all we are left with is a union negotiating further benefits, and there's never a time to say what is reasonable compensation.
All right, so is the House budget headed for a collision course in the Senate over this issue? We'll see. But when it comes to the state spending plan as a whole, the House proposal is filled with deep cuts, and it's been described as everything from reckless to responsible, and party lines certainly have a bit to do with that.
7,000 adults aren't going to get service. 4,000 children aren't going to get services. These are tough decisions that they had to make. Those are decisions that, in my opinion, could be catastrophic in terms of how they affect the populace.
Generally, I think we agree with the speakers that some difficult decisions have to be made. It's a tough time. There's been overspending in the past. But we got to be wise when we make those decisions. And we get a second bite at the apple, and I think there'll be some different details, but I think the overall concepts will still be the same.
Also on the PAC show, a sit-down with possible presidential candidate Ron Paul as the visits to New Hampshire finally are starting to pick up. We'll see you Sunday at 10.